द लर्नेड काउंसिल फॉर द अपीलांट हैज प्लेस्ड रिलायंस ऑन द केस ऑफ मोहसिन वर्सेस रेशमा. इन दिस केस द हाई कोर्ट हैड सेट असाइड द ऑर्डर ऑफ द सिविल जज ग्रांटिंग द कस्टडी ऑफ द चाइल्ड टू हर मदर्स पैटर्नल आंट वाइल द फादर वॉज नॉट proven to be unfit. However, the High Court of Rajasthan held that in the light of Section 19, which bars the court from appointing a guardian when the father of the minor is alive and not unfit, the court could not appoint any maternal relative as a guardian even though the personal law of the minor might give preferential custody in her favor. As is evident, the aforementioned decision concerned appointing of a guardian. No doubt, unless the father is proven to be unfit, the application for guardianship filed by the another person cannot be entertained. However, we have already seen that the question of custody was distinct from that of a guardianship. As far as matters of custody are concerned, the High Court is not bound by the bar envisaged under Section 19 of the Act. In our opinion, as far as the question of custody is concerned, in the light of the aforementioned decisions, the personal law governing the minor girl dictates her maternal relatives, especially her maternal aunt, shall be given preference. To the extent that we are concerned with the question of interim custody, we see no reason to override this rule of Mohammedan law, and hence a prima facie case is found in favor of the respondents. Further, the balance of convenience lies in favor of granting custody to the maternal grandfather, aunt, and uncle. A plethora of decisions of this court endorse the proposition that in matters of custody of children, their welfare shall be the focal point. Once we shift the focus from the rights of the contesting relatives to the welfare of the minor children, the considerations in determining the question of balance of convenience also differ. We take note of the fact that respondent number 2 on record has stated that she has no intention to get married, and her plea that she had resigned from her job as a technical writer to take care of the children remains uncontroverted. We are hence convinced that the respondents will provide sufficient love and care for the children till the final disposal of the guardianship application. A dispute arose between the parties and matters was referred to arbitration. Due to some reasons, arbitration proceedings were not concluded. Respondent filed application before High Court seeking removal of the arbitrator. High Court directed appellant to appoint a new arbitrator and further directed the